Going paperless with chord charts means you no longer have to fumble with paper on stage. With OnSong, you can easily pick a set and start playing without risk of a paper cut or lugging a binder. OnSong now lets you select multiple songs at once to perform actions more quickly. In this tutorial video, we'll show you how. Let's open OnSong and then tap on the Songs menu in the upper left corner. Then let's make sure we are on the All Songs tab. Once you see your list of songs, tap on the Edit button in the upper right corner. The list now goes into an editing mode and the toolbar on the bottom appears. Now let's tap on some songs to select them. You can see as soon as you have some songs selected, the toolbar at the bottom enables so that you can perform actions. Let's tap on the Mark button on the left. This brings up a list of icons that we can place next to the songs. I'm going to pick the star option. Immediately, the star icon is applied and we're taken out of editing mode. Let's repeat that and pick some other songs, including some of the ones that we've already starred. I'll now select Flag. You can see that all the songs now have a flag and the star icon has been replaced. If we want to remove icons, we can do that by using the same process, but choosing None instead. That will remove any icon that has been applied to the song. The new Multiselect tool is really handy for picking sets or organizing your books. Let's say I want to pick a new set while browsing my songs. I can come in here to the All Songs tab and then look for some songs, and then enter editing mode and select them. When I'm all done, I can tap on the Add To button at the bottom, and then tap New Set. There! I've just created a new set with those songs. Let's tap on the My Sets tab over here, and then select Today's Date. You can see the songs are displayed in the order that I had picked them. To change that order, we can tap on the Edit button up here, and then drag the rows using this reordering handle on the right. When we have them just the way we want, tap Done. That's a really quick way to make new sets, but I could also add selected songs to an existing set. Let's go back to our All Songs tab and tap on the Edit button again. When we tap on Add To, we could choose Current Set to add the songs to the set I currently have selected. Let's pick a different set instead. Tap on Set. This displays a set picker screen where I can browse my sets and then tap on one. The songs are then added to the end of that set in the order that I picked them. We can follow the same steps to add these songs to a new or existing book. Multiselect is also available in the By Artist, By Key, and By Topic tabs. Let's go into By Artist and pick an artist. Let's say I want to duplicate some of these songs in my library so that I can change them, but retain the originals. We tap on the More button at the bottom. Here we have a list of actions that we can perform. Let's tap on Duplicate. Now I have copies of those songs that are completely separate from the originals. Maybe we didn't mean to do that, and we want to remove songs we don't use anymore in our library. Let's select the songs we don't want, tap More, and then tap Delete. We are prompted to make sure we don't accidentally delete songs from our library. So let's tap Delete, and they're gone. Okay, not really. You can undelete songs by going into the Utilities menu by tapping on this gear icon, and then choose Tools, locate the Undelete Songs tool, and then we'll see a bunch of songs that we've already deleted. Just select the songs you want to undelete, and then tap Undo. If we go back into our library, we can see they've returned again. Let's say you need to export some songs for use with lyrics projection software, or to let your team know what songs are being played. Let's go back into the Songs menu and tap on All Songs. Now let's select some songs and tap on the More button. At the bottom, we can choose from Email, Export, or Open. Each of these items are similar, but offer different destinations for our exported files. We're going to tap on Email. Here we can choose the file type to export, like PDF. OnSong then opens an email composition screen, and I can type who I want to send the list to. You can also see that songs are written and attached in the order I selected them. Not everyone is lucky enough to have OnSong, so you may need to print songs from time to time. Let's go back into editing mode and select the songs we want to print. Then tap More, and then Print. The print preview screen appears, showing the songs in the order that I had selected them. When we're all ready, we can tap Print and send this directly to an AirPrint printer. If you don't have an AirPrint compatible printer, or would like to learn more about printing from an iOS device, please visit onsongapp.com/airprint. If you have any questions, please be sure to contact us at onsongapp.com/support.